Hi everybody, welcome to this new episode of MSI Procast. Today I'm going to show you how to build your own MSI gaming PC. To help you with your component selection, I've prepared three different setups with three different styles adapted to three different budgets. Let's start by taking a look at our component selection. Our first system is a low-budget setup which costs a bit less than 800 USD. It features an Intel Core i5-7400 Kaby Lake CPU with a MSI B250M Mortar motherboard, 8GB of Corsair Vengeance LPX DDR4 2666 memory. For the storage, we paired a 128GB Corsair MP500 M2 SSD with a Western Digital Caviar Blue hard drive of 1TB. The graphics will be handled by a MSI GeForce GTX 1060 graphics card, which should be enough to play most of the AAA games with the highest settings in 1080p. All this assembled into a Corsair Spec 1 red case with a small but capable Corsair CXM 450 watts power supply. The second build is more stylish with an all-white color scheme. It costs around 1000 USD and features the same components than our low-budget setup, besides a slightly faster Core i5-7500 processor, coupled with an MSI H270 Tomahawk Arctic motherboard. We use the same Corsair Vengeance LPX memory, but this time in white, and the more powerful MSI GeForce GTX 1070 Armor graphics card. I will show you how to build this rig into the white Corsair Spec Alpha chassis, which perfectly matches the motherboard, graphics card, and memory color. Finally comes our gaming enthusiast build. For this one, we went kind of all out. The total cost is around 1500 USD. It features the high-end Z270 Gaming M7 motherboard, an MSI GeForce GTX 1070 Gaming X 8GB graphic card with an Intel Core i7-7700K. We increased the memory to 16GB of DDR4 3000 and the case to Corsair Graphite Series 230T. Since we are using a Z motherboard and K CPU which both allow overclocking, we upgraded the CPU cooling to a Corsair H100i all-in-one water cooling kit and the power supply to a fully modular Corsair RMX 550W, which should give you plenty of room for overclocking. As usual, if you have any question, make sure to leave me a comment below. Now, let's build. Choosing the right motherboard for your gaming rig is very important. Nowadays, motherboard comes in all sorts of flavors and packed with some really cool features. This is an important step as you want to choose a model that fits all your needs. Before choosing, my tip is to ask yourself the following questions. What is your budget? What are you going to do with your computer? What format do you prefer? Mini, micro, or full-size ATX? Do you plan to overclock? And of course, how often will you upgrade? My choice is made, I'm going for the MSI H270 Tomahawk Arctic motherboard. First step is to secure the processor on the motherboard. So we take out the motherboard and place it on a flat surface. Then we open the lid and place the CPU in the socket. If you're not sure which way it goes, look at your CPU and align the two dents on the side and the arrow with the feature of the socket. It will only sit properly this way. Then close the lid and secure the processor. While we are at it, let's also install the M2 SSD. First, remove the screw, insert the SSD into the M2 slot and secure it back with the same screw. That's it. For the cooler, there is nothing complicated. First, rotate each clip into the opposite direction of the printed arrows. Then add a drop of thermal paste at the center of the CPU. Place the cooler, push the pins through, and done. Don't forget to also connect the fan power. Memory, also known as RAM, is key to any gaming rig. MSI offers the widest compatibility on the market with over 1200 compatible memory kits. I've added the link to the full list in the description below. There is only one way to set up memory modules. You have to match the notch on the bottom edge of the RAM with the rise up inside the memory slot. Slide the modules down and push until you hear a click from the retention clips. If you have less than 4 modules, use the DIMM slot guide printed on your motherboard. This will tell you in which slots you need to place your sticks. Now that we've got all the major components secured onto the motherboard, we can proceed and install it inside the case. Oh, and pro tip, don't forget to install the I/O shield before. Take the motherboard and lower it gently into the case. Make sure that it lays flat on all the standoff. Once in position, secure it using all the supply screws. Finally comes the essential component of any gaming rig, the graphics card. This black and white MSI GeForce GTX 1070 Armor will just be perfect. First, remove the corresponding extension port cover from the case. We place the card in the first PCIe slot of our Z270 motherboard. Install the graphics card in the holder and align it to the PCIe slot before securing it to the case. Note that this card uses two I/O bays at the back of our case. Don't cheap out and make sure to use two screws to properly secure your graphic card. For storage, we use two different drives. We've got the M2 SSD which we already installed, and now we just need to add our 1TB hard drive. Securing the drive is nothing complicated. Some cases like this one come with a simple drive setup mechanism. It's quite convenient. Finally, the last piece of the puzzle, the power supply. For this build, we use the Corsair CXM 450W power supply. 450W may not sound like much, but this system will use at most 320W, so we've got more than enough power. Once the power supply is secured, it's cable management time. Make sure to connect all the components together with the right cables and use Velcro strips to tie them nicely together. If your case comes with MSI Mystic Light Sync compatible LED accessories, this is also the right time to connect these to the dedicated 4-pin connector on your motherboard. So that's it, we are done building our gaming system. Don't forget these essential tips. First, pick the right component to fit both your budget and needs. Second, select the memory modules that are certified with MSI motherboard by checking our QVL list on our product page. Third, don't forget to install the I/O shield before mounting the motherboard. And four, make it look cool. If you had to pick one of these systems to go on your desk, which one would it be? The casual gaming rig, the Arctic gaming rig, or the full-out enthusiast gaming rig? Let me know in the comments below. This concludes our video. Give us a thumbs up if you like it or learned something, but if you didn't, let us know why. Thanks for watching and happy gaming!